ओम ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। निरंजनं नित्यमनंतरूपं भक्तानुकंपाद्धृतविग्रहं वै ईशावतारं परमेशमीड्यं तं रामकृष्णं शिरसा नमामि। यथाग्नेर्दाहिका शक्ति रामकृष्णे स्थिता ह्या सर्वविद्यास्वरूपान्तां सारदां प्रणमाम्यहम्। रामाय रामचन्द्राय रामभद्राय वेधसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीतायाः पतये नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। निर्मर्यादस्तु पुरुषः पापाचारसमन्वितः मानं न लभते सत्सु भिन्नचारित्र्यदर्शनः। भगवान रामा इज आर्ग्यूइंग विथ जापाली ऋषि विथ रिगार्ड टू दी नेसेसिटी ऑफ बीइंग ए ट्रूथफुल पर्सन। सत्यमेव जयते इस वेद वाक्य वेदिक रेवलेशन एंड हाउ इट इज असिमिलेटेड इन द लाइव्स ऑफ ग्रेट पीपल एंड हाउ फॉर द सेक ऑफ ट्रूथफुल लाइफ दे वेर रेडी टू सैक्रिफाइस एवरीथिंग इन देयर लाइफ एंड हाउ a person of integrity will be a successful person. These ideals are discussed in Ramayana elaborately. Keeping this Ramayana context, we are analyzing the great ideal satyameva jayate. Satyameva jayate means satyavan eva jayati. A truthful person alone wins. He alone will be successful. He alone was successful, he alone is successful, he alone will be successful. Successful in what sense? Ramji says, he will be successful in all sense. From the standpoint of worldly success, and in that worldly success itself, from the standpoint of success in personal life, success in social life, success in gaining things, whatever he want in his life, and success after the death, and success in gaining the ultimate success called freedom, freedom from all psychological problems. Here Ramji says, Nirmaryadastu purushaha पापाचार समन्वितः मानम न लभते सत्सु भिन्न चारित्र्य दर्शनः। ए पर्सन हु डजंट फॉलो धर्म आर सत्यम ही विल बी द लूसर। ही विल बी द लूसर इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ पर्सनल लाइफ। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी सा व्हाट इज द लॉस। वायलेशन ब्रिंग्स कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इन वन्स माइंड and conflicts makes the person as a split person. Because of split personality, his self dignity is destroyed. Having destroyed his self dignity, whatever he gains in his life as an external achievement will not be useful for him to enjoy. Therefore, the failure is, the loss is in the form of loss of self dignity. Manam na labhate, Bhagavan says, मानम न लभते भिन्न चारित्र्य दर्शनः मानम न लभते। ए पर्सन विथ हिपोक्रेटिक कैरेक्टर विल नॉट हैव रेस्पेक्ट। रेस्पेक्ट फ्रॉम हूम? सो फार रामजी सेज ही विल नॉट गेट रेस्पेक्ट फ्रॉम हिज ओन माइंड, रेस्पेक्ट फ्रॉम हिमसेल्फ। इन हिज जजमेंट ही विल हैव लो सेल्फ इमेज, लो सेल्फ एस्टीम, लो सेल्फ डिग्निटी। दैट इज द ग्रेटेस्ट लॉस। Because all external things, all external achievements human being wants, whether it is education or power, money, wealth, people, name, fame, everything human being wants for the sake of seeing himself as a man of more dignity. For the sake of judging himself as a man of with greater self-dignity, in the process of gaining all these external gains, if he loses his already existing self-dignity, then the external gain is nothing but a loss. In the last class, I told through a imaginary incident of a gold medal winner who got gold medal by copying in the examination. When the external world congratulates him, internal world says, "You are a cheat." Seeing the gold medal, seeing the certificate, when external world says, "Congratulations," his mind says, "Cheat, you are a cheat." Therefore, Ramji says, Satyavan is the real gainer. A person with integrity and truthfulness is the real gainer because he is the strongest person. A person with strength alone can be a winner in anything, any pursuit. Here, what is the strength? Strength to conform to the dharma rules of the life. Conformity to dharma, conformity to satyam is not the sign of weakness, it is the sign of maturity, it is the sign of mental strength. Therefore, he will be successful in any situation in life. Because the violation itself is because of weakness. Something pressurizes him. In spite of his knowledge that it is wrong, still athakena prayuktoyam papam charati purushaha anichannapi varshneya baladiva niyojitaha. Arjuna says, in spite of knowing that I should not do this, why human being is forced to do that? Who is that entity which is forcing or pressurizing? That was the question. That means what? He is vulnerable to external pressure. What is that external pressure? Here, who is forcing him? Not the external world, not even the external gains, but his own desires. Kamayesha krodayeshaha rajogana samudbhavaha mahashano mahapapma vidhi enam vairinam. Bhagavan Krishna says in Gita for the question, what is that pressurizing entity? It is nothing but his own desires. You can see that in a traffic, there is a signal and the red signal is there. People are asked to stand, but there are people who will stop at the signal, but at the same time they will be go on turning the accelerator, darr, darr, like that. That means what? That is the pressure inside. Darr, darr is there, so it outside expresses as when he is going to put release me, that pressure is there. Here the pressure is his own jnana shakti is overpowered by iccha shakti. I told a human being has three types of shakti. One is jnana shakti, another is iccha shakti, third one is kriya shakti. Jnata, bhokta and karta. Jnata knows what is right and wrong. Bhokta wants only certain things according to his understanding, only certain things he wants, and karta runs towards it. Here in this case, what happens? In spite of his knowledge that it is wrong, still he goes towards, that means what? His jnata shakti, jnana shakti is overpowered. A temporary blackout happens. That is why afterwards when he is caught, he cannot show his face. He himself feels that I have done wrong thing. Therefore, Ramji says, when a person can gain everything in life by just sheer being honest and hard working, why should a person should take to the cut shots, a life of cut shots? Ramji asserts this idea. Bhumihi kirtihi yasho lakshmihi purusham prartayantihi satyam samanuvartante satyameva bhajetataha. Whatever may be the external achievements that can be put in these four or five items. Bhumihi, kirtihi, yashaha, name and fame, and lakshmi, wealth. All these things are coming and requesting, as though they are coming and requesting to the man of truthfulness, you please accept us. Because if we are with you, we will be honored. A money with a man of character will be honored. A money with a drunkard will be dishonored. Therefore, Ramji says, wealth comes and begs to this person, please accept us, please accept us. The wealth gained by the adharmic person is not going to enjoy that wealth. That wealth will be what? Will be kept in Swiss bank account. All adharmic money is kept in where? Swiss bank account. Who is enjoying that wealth? Not the owner of the wealth, but the banker of the wealth is enjoying that. You cannot tell outside also that I have a bank account at Switzerland. And you cannot tell what is your password, what is your account number, you cannot tell. But only you can see the passbook, and that too when nobody is there, you can see the passbook and keep it inside. And as even you see the passbook, that $1 million is there, immediately another mind says, this is cheated money, be careful, when CBI will come, when tax wallahs will come, be careful. As even you see the account, you are not using that money, as even you see the account, immediately fear comes and other things come. So, a money, a power, an education, name and fame and an intelligent with a dishonest person is a useless thing. Shakuni Mama was the most intelligent person, equal to Krishna's intelligence. Shakuni Mama, do anybody respect that intelligence? Do anybody respect the intelligence of a terrorist? There are so many terrorists who are caught or found that they are gold medalists. In engineering, they are gold medalists. What is the use of their intelligence? So therefore, Ramji says, your intelligence will not have any value in you as far as your life is concerned. It will not have any value. Maximum, it can blow off yourself by human bombing. It can blow off your body, but it will not be useful for your enjoyment. So Shakuni Mama's intelligence is useless. Ravana's power is useless. Ravana's education was useless. Ravana's name and fame was useless. Because he was not a man of character. And the money by dishonest means, gained by dishonest means will be useless. As I told, it is like Swiss bank money. Therefore, Ramji says, all this wealth, bhumi, kirti, yashas, lakshmi, everything comes and requests the person who is a honest person, requests that person, please accept us, because if we are with you, we will be honored by this society. If we go to the wrong hands, either we will be stashed away, either we will be buried somewhere else, or we will be useless. Therefore, please accept. Therefore, Ramji says, if wealth, power, position, and enjoyments, everything have value in your life, still, all of them have validity as long as you stand as a man of self-dignity. Therefore, self-dignity is the ultimate value in human life. Being truthful improves your self-dignity. Being pretentious destroys your self-dignity. Therefore, don't get wrong certificate from yourself. When you are interested in getting certificate from the external world that you are educated, that you are wealthy, that you are rich man, that you are powerful person, that you have a lot of big post, but still, if you don't get certificate from yourself, all other certificates will be what? Useless certificate. It is like ornaments given to the dead body. Ornaments adorning the dead body, it will be like that. Therefore, self-certificate is very, very important. Even when the whole world considers a person as great, as long as that particular individual doesn't consider himself as great, this other certificate will not be available for him to enjoy. In our Guru Parampara, my Acharya used to say this one small joke. It seems there was a beauty parlor association. Beauty parlor workers association. We all know beauty parlor. What is beauty parlor? In olden days, they used to call saloon shop. Nowadays, it is called beauty parlor. So, beauty parlor workers association members, they used to celebrate every year annual celebration. That year, they wanted to have a cultural program and they decided that we will enact Ramayana as a drama. So they inquired the drama group. Drama group charged 50,000 rupees. So these beauty parlor workers association members, they did not have that much money. So they thought, why should we give 50,000 to others? Let us try. We ourselves will try to enact this drama. So all the members agreed. Each member was given one role. One member was given Rama role, another member was Dasharatha role, another member was Vishwamitra role, another member was Sita role, like that. So rehearsal happened, dialogues are written, and dialogues are by-hearted, and there was a director who was organizing everything, and annual celebration day, evening, 6 o'clock, drama started. The scene was, Dasharatha Raja was sitting on his throne, and Rama was 16-year-old boy. That time, Vishwamitra comes to Dasharatha's palace, asking help from Dasharatha by sending Rama to protect the Yaga. This story you know. This is the scene. Dasharatha Raja is sitting on the throne. The screen opened. Vishwamitra has to come. That is the scene. So as even Vishwamitra ji is coming, this security guard announces, Vishwamitra has come. Vishwamitra has come. As even Dasharatha Raja heard this announcement, immediately he stood up and wanted to invite the Vishwamitra and goes ahead of Vishwamitra and invites him. Aye, Vishwamitra ji, please come, Vishwamitra ji, baithiye, please sit. Then Vishwamitra sat. Then this Dasharatha says, should I do cutting or shaving? Then the director was wondering, this cutting or shaving cannot be uttered by Dasharatha Raja. It can be uttered by beauty parlor association member only. So how a Dasharatha Raja can utter cutting or shaving? Like that this director was wondering. Then they found, even though external world has decorated him as Dasharatha Raja, his internal world is what? External world has certified him as Dasharatha Raja, at least temporarily. Nobody has certified us so far, at least. At least costume wise they have certified and made him to be a Dasharatha Raja, at least for 2 hours or 2.5 hours. Till that time, instead of enjoying that temporarily given status, this beauty parlor workers association mind is there, na? That mind doesn't go cutting, because Vishwamitra ji was having lot of dadi, beard and mustache and unbridled hair. So seeing that, his own inner opinion. What is his opinion about himself? I am a beauty parlor worker association member. I am a worker in beauty parlor. I can never imagine or dream myself as a king, and that too, the king like Dasharatha, and that too, father of Rama. Where I am not able to father ordinary Rama. Where is the question of fathering the Bhagavan Rama? So that was his opinion. So external certificate, even if it is given for the sake of drama, at least for the sake of drama, he could have owned up that status. But still that mind is beggarly mind. So therefore it says, cutting or shaving. So as long as a person considers himself as a small person, as long as a person's beggarliness is there in his mind, the person continues to be a small person, beggarly person, in spite of his education, in spite of his power given by the society. India is suffering because of type of people like beauty parlor Dasharatha Raja. External world has given them, the government has given them IAS, IPS, advocate, doctor, like that status it is given. This person refused to accept himself as IAS officer. As an administrator of the entire district, he should be a man of giving, correct? An administrator of the entire district should be a man of giving. Man of giving what? Welfare activities designed by the government to the society. For him, government is paying. But this person refused to accept that status of giver and he continues to be the beggar. What is the meaning of a beggar? A beggar is one who doesn't know about his self-dignity. A beggar is one who doesn't have the confidence that I can work hard and earn. A beggar is one who can sell his self-dignity for small money. Correct? That is the definition. You just go to any government office in India, almost all the offices in India, government offices especially, when you go for small job, whether it is certificate, birth certificate, or what you call land certificate, some certificate, and the person invites you, IA, IA. He invites you. As even you give your application, he sees that according to the eligibility rules and laws, he should give the certificate. But instead of giving that certificate right and royal, instead of being a giver, he asks for extra money, easy money, putting his own self-dignity of being a giver. He puts down that giver status and he expects extra money. What you call him? What should we call him? We should call him powerful beggar. We should call him educated beggar. Postwala beggar. Ordinary roadwala beggar can beg because he is illiterate person. Nobody has taught him. Nobody has given him degree or IAS or IPS position or doctor or engineering position. Nobody has given him. Therefore, he doesn't have self-confidence that he can earn and live his life. Therefore, he sells his already existing small self-dignity and he gets easy money. The same beggarliness exists in the so-called educated people because of this educated Dasharathas only. Educated Dasharathas only this India is suffering. And how much education? If you go to statistics, not even 17% of Indian population are degree holders. If 17% of degree holders can create this much of havoc, if 17% of degree holders, educated people, can plunder this nation this much, you imagine 100% becomes degree holders in India. What will happen? Country will not be there. That is the education we are getting, wherein there is no place for study of life. There is no place for values. Therefore, for modern age, this idea is very, very important that I can live life with uprightness. I can win the life with being a truthful person. So, Ramji asks, having sold yourself, having sold your self-respect for the small money. That's what you see, all these scams, behind all these scams that happened in India, who is there? Only educated people, not an illiterate farmer, not a single illiterate farmer, only educated people. If education is meant to sell your self-dignity, if education is meant to plunder the society from which you are born and brought up and got education, and if that is the purpose of education, that is the benefit of education, then what is the use of that education? So therefore, Ramji says, it is a waste having sold yourself. You see, an air marshal has sold himself for paltry money. Air marshal! While purchasing the helicopter, he has sold himself. What is lacking? Which is lacking in his life? What is not given by the society and government? For an air marshal, for a minister, for an IAS officer, for a principal secretary. How many fellows are in jails now? Of course, they are coming out, that is different. But it is not a permanent release. So therefore, education should help one to live a life of self-dignity. Power should help one to live a life of self-dignity. Position should help one to live a life of self-dignity. Because all these things human mind wants to increase his self-dignity. Therefore, Ramji says, never give up, never sell your self-dignity and gain something. Whatever comes at the cost of your self-dignity will not be helpful for you to enjoy. Somebody will enjoy. There will be one house, 40 room bedded house, even if it is 40 bedded house, and it will not be in your name, it will be in Binami name. And you will be afraid always whether that fellow will take, even though you are living there in 40 bedded house, how many bedroom you can use, you tell. Can you lie down in each bedroom 5 minutes? My Acharya Swamiji used to tell, even if the person is the owner of the costliest car, if he sits in front seat, he cannot occupy the back seat.
You are so limited. As long as you have an idea that I am a small person, any amount of external additions are not going to make you the idea, to change your idea that I am small. Therefore, Ramji says, having judgment from yourself, having certificate from yourself is very, very important. All other certificates may be a necessity, but it will not have any validity unless you give such proper certificate to yourself. And you can never cheat yourself, because one fellow is there always observing you and always accompanying you, always voting for right thing only. Buddhihi sarvada jnana pakshapadihi. Shastra says this buddhi is there, na? It will only vote for knowledge only. Even when it is voting for error, as far as that buddhi is concerned, that buddhi thinks that it is right, therefore it is voting. So therefore, Ramji says, never give up your self-respect. Gaining anything at the cost of self-respect will be loss, and violation destroys your self-respect. Therefore, satyavaneva jayate. Then another idea. Ramji is the greatest psychiatrist. He says, as a human being, normal human being, you can never be with dishonesty. Because it's a beautiful idea. One should think over this. So far he has explained the laws of violation. Now he says, it is impossible to be an untruthful person. It is impossible for any human being to be untruthful. How is it we find lot of people are untruthful? Ramji says, because they are indoctrinated. Therefore, they are untruthful. As a neutral person, without any indoctrination from the society, without any indoctrination from the religious people, if you take the neutral person, and he will hold on only to the right things in his life. What is the proof? Ramji says, being dharmic is your intrinsic nature. Therefore, never try to be adharmic. This trying to be adharmic will not long last, because it is not your intrinsic nature. What is the proof? Beautifully, one teacher describes this. So there is a novel. The author has described varieties of characters in that novel. And those characters will be what? Hero character, villain character, heroine character, joker character, like that, ne? But the author never says, so-and-so character is hero character. Suppose you go to a cinema. The director of the cinema, he presents the characters, varieties of characters. The director of the cinema presents varieties of characters. No character has a board that I am hero, I am villain. Is there any board, any sticker is there on their forehead? Or do they have any board? But the viewer, the seer, one who witnesses the cinema or one who reads this novel, he says, this fellow is hero, this character is heroic character, that character is villain character. Ramji asks, how you know? So-and-so behavior is heroic behavior, and that is invariably always good behavior. If good behavior is branded as heroic behavior, that means without others branding it, when you yourself brand by your own judgment, even if you are a villain type of person, when you see a hero, when you see a person with good character, how you brand him? He is a hero. That's what in Ramayana, even Ravana says, Rama is hero. Ravana says. Maricha says, Maricha is another villain. Correct? Maricha was another source of suffering for Rama. Maricha says, Ramo Vigrahavan Dharmaha. This certificate from whom? From the opposite party. From opposition party this certificate is given. Ramo Vigrahavan Dharmaha. Maricha says, Ravana, if you want to give a form to the unseen factor called dharma, to the unseen factor called what is honesty, it's a concept. So if you want to give a form, and that form will be exactly as Rama's form.
This certificate is given by whom? Not by admirers of Rama, but by the opposition party. Ramo Vigrahavan Dharmaha. That's what we find as a neutral person. Whenever we see a cinema, whenever we read a novel, immediately our mind says, this is the grand character. Therefore, this character should be termed as hero character. This character is not up to the mark of human values. Therefore, it should be termed as villain character. Therefore, don't get indoctrinated. Don't allow your mind to be indoctrinated. Unless a person's mind is indoctrinated with a particular idea or attitude, he can never be an adharmic person. See, killing someone or hurting someone is painful. Everybody knows. Killing someone or hurting someone is a source of pain. Everybody knows. That is why he doesn't want others to kill him, others to hurt him. He also knows. But when he is ready to kill others, what does it mean? Ramji says he is indoctrinated. He is indoctrinated. That indoctrination may be from the external society or may be from religious theologians. So take the terrorists, jihadists. What is their idea? They know they are not going to live after this encounter, correct? They are going to blow off themselves. But still they are ready to do. Why? Because of indoctrination. You can blow off yourself, but still you will be available there. There is no proof. After death, whether the person is available or not, as far as this person is concerned, no proof. His sense organ cannot prove that. But still he has a belief, and the belief was inserted. That is called unverified beliefs inserting is called indoctrination. And you will have 9 wives there. One killing here will give you 9 wives there. Where? In heaven. When? After death. So this indoctrination happened when the person terrorist, the jihadi, was just 12 year, 13 year or 14 year old boy. Correct? Similarly, when we are children, we are indoctrinated by the society in many ways. Knowingly or unknowingly, our immediate surrounding says, you have to win the race somehow or the other. The somehow or the other is called indoctrination. The society, if it is an enlightened society, it will tell you cannot win the race somehow or the other. But this is an idiotic society, and it says you have to win the race by somehow or the other, by hook or crook. That is impossible. Therefore, never allow your mind to be indoctrinated by either by the immediate society or by the religious theologies or religious people. And materialist indoctrination is what? Be a consumer at any cost. Perfect man. Raymond Schutz. What is the connection between perfect man and this is called indoctrination? Perfect man. Raymond Schutz. If a coat and shoot can make a person as a perfect man, that means all dolls in the showroom can be perfect man. This idea is from Western culture. When Swami Vivekananda went to America, that time itself this idea was there. Swamiji rebuked this idea. It seems when Swami Vivekananda went to America without any money, he did not know where to go. He did not have anyone to accept him as a guest. So without knowing where to go, and that Parliament of Religion was postponed for 3 months, he lost the address of a friend and he was staying in a goods train. Next day morning, he was sitting on the platform. A neighbor saw that mother came and talked to the Swami, and within few minutes she understood this person is a very cultured person and he has come with a purpose. Therefore, she invited him as her guest and took Swami Vivekananda to her house. And she gave a beautiful accommodation and a dress also, beautiful coat and suit. According to that mother, that sannyasi dress, that is dhoti and chadar, will be a beggarly dress. So therefore, Swami should not have this. So he should have the local dress, a dignified gentleman dress. What is that? Coat and suit. So Swamiji took bath and wore the new coat and suit. And when he came out, this mother was really happy to see, because he is now looking very fair and nice also. So she told to Swami Vivekananda, "Swami, half an hour before you look like a beggar, now you look like a gentleman." And for Swami Vivekananda, this cannot be a truth. Because half an hour before also he was Swami Vivekananda, now also he is Swami Vivekananda. Half an hour before also same person, now also same person. Only difference is dress. How a dress can make a person as gentleman? Then humorously he told, "Mother, it seems in America tailors make gentlemen. But in our India, only a man of character will be called as gentleman." See the strength of mind. This is what success. See the strength of mind. Nobody was there even to give one time food. That was the condition. Care of platform. No food, no dress, no accommodation. In that condition, a person can assert his self-dignity based on his character. That is the success in life. And if that mother would have been angry, suppose, what would have happened? "Oh, you have come to my country and you are ridiculing my own civilization like that." If she gets angry and throws him away, what will happen? Swami Vivekananda never bothered about. What is fact, because a dress can never make a person as a gentleman. Gentlemanliness, according to Indian culture, gentlemanliness is nothing but his refined character. Therefore, Ramji says, never allow yourself to be indoctrinated by the materialistic philosophies. Materialistic philosophy means what? Consumerist philosophy. Consume, consume, consume. Perfect gentleman, Raymond shoots. Good times, Kingfisher. What is the, these are all good times, Kingfisher. You can put good times, meditation, you can put, accept. But good times, Kingfisher means what? Those who don't have that Kingfisher drink, have bad time. This is called indoctrination. She deserves more. One diamond advertisement. I see all these advertisements. She deserves more. How the fellow knows? Whether she deserves more or not, only husband can know, or father or mother or somebody has to know. This fellow is diamond seller. He says in his advertisement, "She deserves more." Then that amma also says, "See, the diamond seller knows my value. Paranga, ungalku onnum theriyala. You are not recognizing my value." These are all indoctrination. These are all indoctrination. So, never allow yourself to be indoctrinated by materialistic philosophy, nor allow yourself indoctrinated by theologians' unverified dogmas and doctrines. That there is a God sitting in heaven and he doesn't have form, but he is sitting and watching you. He doesn't have form, but sitting on a throne. He doesn't have form, having a crown. Imagine, these are all dogmas and doctrines. There is no proof. A formless entity sitting on a throne having a crown. Imagine. Acharya Swamiji used to say, it's a big pumpkin. But people are able to swallow this. Not only they swallow, they come and they recommend for others also. And that too in India. There is a God, formless God. He is sitting there and watching you. He loves you, but he will give judgment to you. See, contradictions. He loves you, but will be a judge at the judgment day. Imagine. God has only one son, and that God doesn't have form. Imagine. A formless God having a son. These are all theologies. What is meant by that scripture is different. If you allow the Vedantin to interpret that same statements, Vedantin will interpret without contradicting our human logic. But these theologians create a problem which is not existing, that a person lived as Adam and he committed a small mistake. Therefore, entire humanity is condemned as a sinner. See, somebody has sinned and it is not a sin at all. Eating an apple is not a sin at all. But still, it is considered okay, it is considered as a sin. But still, how can that can be taken, carry forward to the entire humanity? The very birth of the human body is a act of sin. Therefore, you are born with original sin and you have to be saved by the Son of the Lord, and we are His representatives. Come to us. These are all theological indoctrinations. Same scripture can be interpreted by Vedantins, by Indian mind, in another way. If Jesus says that I am the Son of the Lord, the same Jesus told, pray to the Lord that, oh, our Father in heaven. Whose Father? The praying person's Father is in heaven. Correct. Therefore, Jesus says, your Father is in heaven. And the church says, your Father is Adam. Which one I should believe? Which one I should believe? Christ says, Bible says, my Father is in heaven. And church says, my Father is Adam. So, Christ says, I am Son of the Lord. Church says, I am Son of the sinner. Which one I should believe? So, scripture should be interpreted properly, and misinterpreted scripture is called theology, and theology will be always a threat to the human society. Therefore, never allow yourself indoctrinated by either materialistic ideas or by theological ideas. Accept your natural goodness. Individual, by nature he is good, because he is antaratma, is what? Nothing but Amritasya Putra. Every individual is an Amritasya Putra. He is a son of the Lord. He is an embodiment of love. He is an embodiment of Satya. Therefore, one should not try to go beyond his nature. What is his nature? Purity is his nature. Up to this, relevance of following Satyam in personal life. Now, Ramji is going to tell what is the relevance of following Satyam in social life. So, we will chant the same mantra. Nirmaryadastu purushaha papachara samanvitaha manam na labhate satsu bhinna charitya darshanaha. This shloka was interpreted in the previous section. How? Manam na labhate. A person who violates will be a man of hypocrisy, therefore he will not get respect. Manam na labhate means he won't get respect. Respect from whom? Respect from his own inner conscience. Respect from himself. That is the loss. Now the same shloka can be interpreted. Manam na labhate from the society. Neither your mind will accept nor the society will accept. In the previous argument, what? Society may accept for some time, but still it will be a loss because your mind will not accept. Now Ramji says, society itself will not accept you, because society invariably demands truthfulness from every member of the society. Papachara samanvitaha manam na labhate. If a person is truthful, that person gets respect from the society. If he is untruthful, the society rejects him. Even if, when we see these untruthful people are respected, society considers them as truthful. As long as society considers them as truthful, up to that time only respect is possible. Once society understood that this person is not a truthful person, immediately the given respect will be withdrawn. That is why even those untruthful people has to pretend as though they are truthful. Correct? Even if he is untruthful, he cannot openly come and say, I am an untruthful person. I will never follow the truth. Let me see whether you respect me or not. Can anybody say? Even all these bogus people who don't follow the values in life, they also, when they are caught by police, what they tell? We are innocent. Correct? We never did that. Many scams are brought out to the public light. So all the people are arrested. And when they were arrested, what was their assertion? We never did it. It's all politically motivated. Vendetta. So they could have told, yes, I did it. If you have guts, you can punish me. Can they tell? No. Because they can never project themselves as untruthful. and get the respect simultaneously. Therefore, society will punish once it finds the member of the society is untruthful. It will not allow the person to survive in the society. That's why people who are caught in these nightclubs and rave parties and other places, when they come out, when they are brought to jail, how they come out? They close their face. Correct? They close their face. That means what? They themselves know this is not the face to be shown to the society. If it is shown to the society will throw stones on this face. When you yourself know that it is not the face to be shown to the society, how can you accept that face to yourself? Therefore, Ramji says, society will never accept. If a person declares that I want entire wealth in the country, therefore I will do anything whatever I like, I will do all types of cheating. Suppose a person declares, imagine, I will be the owner of entire Madras city. Will the person be alive? Same night people will kill him. Correct? So Ramji says, Manam na labhate, bhinna charitre darshanaha, Manam na labhate. Society will not accept you. Therefore, it will not respect you. And without getting respect in the society, another logic, without getting respect in the society, what success you are going to have in society in your life, you tell? What success you can have? Can a person be successful in society without getting respect from the society? Or can a person pretend, even though he is not truthful, can he pretend whole life that he is truthful, truthful, truthful? It is impossible. So, Ramji says, how can I continue to pretend whole life? What will happen if I am found I am an hypocrite? If I found that I am an hypocrite, what will happen to me? What will happen to the success which is gained already? So far, by hypocrisy, he has gained a lot of position, power, success, everything. What will happen once he is caught? Will it be given to him? No, it will not be given to you. Therefore, Ramji says, one has to demonstrate one's truthfulness in his day-to-day life. Life alone determines the quality of a person. Life alone determines the quality of the respect a person gets from the society. Kulinam akulinam va viram purushamaninam charitrameva vyakhyati shuchim va yadi va shuchim. What is the criterion to judge the quality of the person? Charitram eva vyakhyati. His life is the litmus test for his character. You cannot pretend whole life. Whole life, you cannot pretend. And pretension is always painful, you know. Telling lie is always painful because you have to remember all the lies. You have 4 or 5 friends. Okay, you tell one thing to one friend. And you tell another thing to the another friend. And you have to remember which lie I told to the which person. Your family member asks where you went. You went to some party or somewhere else. You cannot tell this to your family member. So you say, I went to some inspection. With whom? That amma in house, she will not allow with one word answer. So she will, with whom you went? With so and so I went. That so-and-so person, just that day he came. So what you have to tell? And there was an old cinema, I remember. Kalyana Parisu. There was Tangavelu one. So full of lie. And he will claim to his wife that he is the manager of, what is that company? Mannaran Company. Mannaran Company. And that person is taken to one house and a girl is, they are seeing a girl to marry him. So therefore that time the father-in-law, the proposed father-in-law is asking where you are working. Mannaran Company. Mannaran Company. Because the proposed father-in-law is owner of Mannaran Company. Mannaran Company? Which Mannaran Company? How many Mannaran Companies are there? Like that he will manage. And finally, he will be ridiculed. Correct? So a liar has to remember all the lies, first thing, problematic thing it is. So we have to remember all the lies, and then which lie is told to which person. Anywhere short circuit means what? Problem, confusion in family life, confusion. Therefore, charitrameva vyakhyati, life is the litmus test whether a person is a quality person or not. Character alone determines the quality of the person. Here Ramji says, purusham va iti charitram eva vyakhyati. Whether he is a human being at all is determined by whom? What? By character. Human being is supposed to have particular character, particular behavior, particular attitude, particular philosophy, particular vision. So if he doesn't have, then how can we call him as human being? Even though he is with human body, we cannot call him as human being. Purusham va iti, how to know? Charitram eva vyakhyati. Like animals, a person decides that without dress I will go everywhere. What to call him? We have to brand him either animal or man. So, viram purusham va iti, whether he is a courageous man or not, how to know? By his life, by his character. Maninam purusham va iti, purusham va, viram purusham va, maninam purusham va. Whether he is human being at all, or whether he is a courageous human being, having the courage to follow the right things alone in his life, and maninam purusham va means whether he is a man of self-respect. How to know? Charitram eva vyakhyati. Then he goes, kulinam akulinam va, whether he has come with the proper lineage or not. That's what when somebody asked Swami Vivekananda, Swami Vivekananda was describing the grandness of Buddha's character and Buddha's kindness to the fineness of human mind he was describing. And it was about 500 BC. Then one person from the audience asked, if India had such a grand personality like Buddha, why he did not come to Europe? That was the question. Swamiji casually replied, that time you people are where staying on the tree. Where was Europe? There was no Europe. 500 BC, there was no Europe. 2500 years before, there was no Europe. You people are all staying where? Top of the tree now. You people lived like monkeys. So how to tell? You imagine, Buddha comes to monkeys group and starts his philosophy. What will happen? So, kulinam akulinam va, whether your ancestors are grand people, whether you have come from the grand lineage or not, how to know? That is why Western culture says the origin of human being is what? Monkey. A mother was teaching a child, and she was teaching about the ancestors, who were all human ancestors. So she was telling that I am from Bharadwaja Gotra, and there was a Rishi called Bharadwaja. So we are all from Rishi Gotra. We are from Rishi Parampara, like that she was telling. Then child asked, Mummy, yesterday only father told that we have come from monkeys. Yesterday father has taught Darwin theory. Okay, Darwin theory was taught by father yesterday. Today mother is talking from the Indian perspective of evolution. So she was telling, we are all from Rishi Gotra, like that she was telling. Then child asked, Mummy, yesterday only father told that we are from monkeys. Then mother told, your father's lineage is that only. Mother's lineage is Rishi Parampara. So kulinam akulinam va, charitram eva vyakhyati. 1000 years before, people who did not have proper dress, therefore we have condemned them as tribal people, uncultured people, correct? Not able to cover their body in a proper way, not able to present themselves in a society with proper decorum. That was the start of civilization. And we have started one new civilization, and we have found out the cloth and try to present ourselves in a beautiful way and a proper way. Now where this culture is going? Same tribal culture is coming. Now half dress, quarter dress. So kulinam akulinam va charitram eva vyakhyati. Then shuchim va yadiva ashuchim. Whether he is a man with purity or not, what is the criterion to judge him? His character. This is one meaning. Another meaning, see, Valmiki Ramayana is a treasure house of ideas. Another meaning is whether the person is a quality person or not, how to judge? Neither by birth, nor by power, nor wealth, nor education, nor his lineage, nor his courage. None of these things are the criteria for judging a person. Only character is the criterion for judging a person. Therefore, if the person doesn't have character with himself, and if he has all other things, he cannot present himself to the society, because society will not respect the degree, society will not respect the intelligence, will not respect money, will not respect the power, position, nothing it respects unless a person is a man of character. Because characterless power, characterless education, wealth and position, all will be disturbance to the society. Therefore, society will not respect. So he has to pretend himself. Even though he is a cantankerous person, he has to present himself as a man of character. What are all the possible pretension? Ramji says, anaryastu arya samsthanah shauchadinastatha shuchihi lakshanyavad alakshanyo dushilashilavaniva. Pretensions can be in many ways. Anaryaha, ignoble person, a cantankerous person has to pretend himself as a noble person. Arya samsthanah, continuing to be a cantankerous person, still to get the social respect, he has to present himself as a noble person. Shauchad inaha, a dirty fellow, has to present himself as a clean person. That's why people who are not able to keep their body clean, what they do? Put scent. No other way. Because if without scent, if you present yourself in the society, people will not talk to you. Therefore, you know that with smell, this body smell or something, so you cannot present yourself. So you have to put additional scent. And the problem is, this scent and that scent create one more scent. So, shauchat heenaha, dirty fellow, has to present himself as a clean person. Alakshanyaha san, avalakshanya, alakshanyaha means avalakshanyaha. No lakshana at all, no definition at all for his life. And he has to present himself as lakshanyavati. Dushilaha, shilavaniva. So, why this pretension? How much pain it will be, you know, that will be described in the next class.
सत्यव्रतं सत्यपरं त्रिसत्यं सत्यस्य योनिं निहितं च सत्ये सत्यस्य सत्यं मृतसत्यनेत्रं सत्यात्मकं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्नाः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।